Welcome to Let's Talk. Hi everyone, Judy here. Thank you for tuning in. If you don't know, I upload one video to this series each and every week. To be clear, I respect all people from the whole world and their various religious beliefs. But I don't think that using religions as tools to rule the country is good for the country or the people. And I think that if a government uses one of the religions as a tool to rule the country, it'll put women and girls into disastrous situations. Why? Almost all the founders of those religions were born in ancient times. And during those times, women weren't treated as equal as men. Usually, women were treated as second-class citizens. Or worse, they were treated as men's property or belongings. If you don't think that my view is right, please take a good look at the situation of Afghan women. If you don't think that the extremists in other religions won't do the same kind of things, please check out which women's rights have already been taken away by those extremists. So, my conclusion is this. Don't let government use religions as tools to rule the country. Otherwise, you'll end up living in a country like Afghanistan. In general, after Taliban took power in 2021, in 2023, two-thirds of population need to survive solely on humanitarian assistance, almost three times as many as in 2021. As for women and girls, over the last 2 years, the Taliban have issued 54 edicts that directly target women and girls. First, they banned girls from attending secondary schools. Yeah, they didn't just ban books. They did worse. In December 2022, they banned all women from studying. Moreover, they didn't only ban abortion rights. They also did worse on this issue. They banned the sale of contraception in 2023. So much so, Afghanistan had one of the highest rates of maternal mortality in the world. According to UN estimates, every 2 hours an Afghan woman dies during pregnancy or while giving birth due to young age and poor medical care. What's more, during the past 2 years, women have been banned from moving around in public space unless they are in the company of a male relative. And if they go out, they have to wear full veils. So, what do you think, my friends? Do you agree with me now? Okay, my friends, in case you don't know me yet, I'm Judy Fay London, a fan of Jack London. I'm a published writer who writes fiction and nonfiction novels and short stories. You're very welcome to visit my website, judyfaylondon.com or Amazon to read my poems and my short stories. The last one, Mr. Right, Candy the Dog, and so on, and my latest non-fiction book, Living with the Walking Dead, a roadmap for achieving your own success. I hope to see you there, and I thank you so much for your kind support, and thank you very much for subscribing to my YouTube channels, Judy Fay London and Judy Plus. Judy Fay London is a comprehensive channel, while Judy Plus is a channel that talks about interesting scientific discoveries. Thank you for watching, subscribing, liking, sharing, and commenting. I wish you nothing but success and happiness. Let's talk next time. Bye.